subscribe to my channel. Thanks. Amy Dickman has had a number of narrow escapes during her years working with big cats, but her closest shave came when tackling lion-killing warriors. It was late evening and Amy Dickman was walking through the bush to a household she suspected was celebrating a lion kill. It was dark, but I suddenly got the feeling I was being watched, Dickman recalls. I was concerned that a big cat might be lying in wait. For a brief moment the moon appeared from behind the clouds, illuminating the landscape. I realized I was surrounded by young men carrying spears. Then it went dark again. I was terrified, she says. This was Dickman's first encounter with warriors from the Barabaig, a community with a history of killing non-Barabaig people and still widely feared. A conservation biologist from Devon, Dickman has been running a big carnivores project in Ruaha, southern Tanzania, since 2009. An estimated 3,000 lions, 1 in 10 of the world's wild population, live in the remote region, a massive unfenced national park, bounded by tribal lands. Dickman knew she had to make contact with Barabaig warriors to find out whether humans and big cats were coming into conflict, so when she heard sounds of celebration she set off with 2 volunteers. What they hadn't realized